For centuries, the Firstborn lay hidden, scheming to corrupt their enemies. Lady Airfall spun webs of gold to draw the Yalain to her, and corrupted them, until even their Empress obeyed her whims. Ages passed, and still Airfall abided. Many challenged her, but none laid her to rest. At last, she saw her chance. Balzaron had returned. She had faced the Hope Slayer twice before, and both times gained nothing. Now she swore the Firstborn would triumph. All they needed was the book. The Mage Academy, they called it. A school for Dareth's most promising wizards, seething with arcane mysteries. No one knew how it came to possess the wealth of lore within its depths. But they came anyway. They trained under the greatest teachers of the age. But these halls of learning were also a trap. Through deception and illusion, the undead Lord Rytherin used the Academy to seduce the powerful. Subtly, he ensnared the wizards. Day by day, century by century, he taught the sorcerers of Yelaine their true lesson: to serve the will of the Firstborn. Bloodhorn was the greatest of the Gurog chiefs. Cunning and ruthless, he slew his rivals and united the tribes. Jaraen went to Bloodhorn's court, offering power and riches. In return, he asked one thing: his service. But the chief was proud. He challenged Jaraen, thinking to slay him and be done. He was mistaken. Before Bloodhorn could land his first blow, the Firstborn's magic destroyed him. The shamans bowed, naming Jaraen their new king. Thus, with a single spell, the Gurog became thralls to darkness. The Gurog were only the first to follow the undead. Now the Firstborn's eyes turned elsewhere, to the Tumarok jungles and human forests. With Jaraen's aid, the Barun came to worship the Gurog gods. In return, they too would have others to serve them. Even a slave feels royal if he has another to command. The drudges were all too eager for deities to revere, if it meant a chance to kill humans. They built idols to the Barun and threw down Cragstone and the other human cities. The Firstborn looked on and laughed. Their forces had vanquished Dareth at last. Hope Slayer had never been more powerful than on that last day. He had learned much since his last defeat, and his fury made the Earth's bones groan with agony. The world would pay at last for his torment. But Acheron had not been idle either. He had learned to tap dormant energy that no Empyrean had ever touched. His aspect as he confronted Balzaron was that of a god, wrathful and awesome to behold. The Verindi Imperator watched, the forces of portal space at his command. He could not defeat both foes at once, but a weakened victor would be an easy target. He bided, waiting to launch his own attack. They were the Great Ones, titans of inestimable might. None knew how the battle would end, only that when it did, only one would remain, and Dereth would be his prize. But something went wrong. Geraint watched the battle, loathing them all. The Imperator could not imagine his own defeat. The Hopeslayer's wrath was empty at its core, and Acheron. His nobility filled Geraint's heart with hatred. None of them would triumph. He would undo them all. In the end, the Firstborn did not find the book. It found them. To Geraint, it revealed the secrets he desired. Long-lost glyphs that gave power over the Menhir stones, the key to Dereth's magic. Armed with this lore, Geraint stole the Menhir and sealed them within the vaults. Without them, the magic had nothing to contain its power. The Great Ones knew nothing of the doom awaiting them. Geraint watched and smiled. Acheron was the first. He unleashed a devastating spell against the Hopeslayer. Had it succeeded, Balzaron would have fallen at last. He called upon the Menhir to channel the magic, but to his horror, they were not there. The spell went wild. It ripped through Acheron, burning him from within. He tried to stop it, but could not. Not without the Menhir. Geraint shouted with horrible joy as Acheron's own power consumed him. Even then, the spell did not die. The Imperator, who rejoiced to see Acheron fall, cried out as it turned on him. Already afire with portal magic, he could not stand before it. His shrieks echoed into eternity. Balzaron stood alone. With a rage to shatter the heavens, he hurled all his power at it. As it tore him apart, he cursed whoever had wrought this destruction. From his vantage, Geraint ended the spell. For centuries, the Great Ones had been obstacles to his ambitions. Now they were gone, victims of their own pride. At last, Dereth's remains were his to claim.